Hi, I'm Alicia, and today we're going to show you how to write better meta descriptions. Ready to get more clicks? Let's talk about meta descriptions and how to write better meta descriptions to improve your click-through rate. But before we get too far, remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, first, let's talk about what meta descriptions are. Search engines like Google use a robot called a web crawler to index your site. The info this gives them allows them to display it properly in search results so you can be found when people search for relevant keywords. But since this program is just, well, a program, it doesn't automatically know what your site is about. You have to tell it using different elements, such as sitemaps, schema markup, and meta tags, just to name a few. That's why a meta description is so important. Users see a page's meta description below the title in the search results. The meta description is meant to inform them about the content and purpose of a website so they can decide whether to click on it or not. In this example, you can also see site links. Google's crawlers are better than they once were. In fact, they can now extract a title and meta description automatically and figure out a page's topic without you having to manually define keywords. If you don't write your own meta description, Google will generate one for you by pulling content from the page. Meta descriptions actually don't have a direct effect on your SEO ranking, yet Google still advises to create unique ones for each page of your site. It's the keywords found naturally in your content that are important for SEO. What meta descriptions do impact is click-through rate, or how many people decide to click on your site. Think about the last time you Googled something. What made you pick a certain link? It was probably the title, the description, or both that convinced you. According to Backlinko, unique meta descriptions have a major impact on click-through rate, which is commonly abbreviated CTR. Writing unique meta descriptions for each page can increase your site's organic CTR. We found that pages with a meta description had a 5.8% higher CTR compared to pages without a description. Search engines may automatically generate a snippet, but if that description doesn't do a good job conveying what your content is about, people will ignore it and choose another site. Writing your own meta descriptions ensures that you have more control over what people see. I said more control, not total control. Google won't always use your meta description. Sometimes it will show parts of a page's content that's more relevant to a user's search. But in most cases, it prefers to fall back to the snippet you provided rather than using an auto-generated one. A well-written meta description plays a big part in attracting and converting visitors. It may not directly affect SEO, but it will gain you more interested visitors, and higher CTR does give your ranking a boost. When it comes to meta descriptions, there are no hard or fast rules to follow, but there are still some best practices you should keep in mind. These can help you rise above the competition and increase your click-through rate. Let's go over each of these best practices so you can write better meta descriptions. Your meta descriptions can be as short as you want, but don't go over 155 to 160 characters, or it's likely to be cut off abruptly. That doesn't look good. It's a good idea to include a keyword in every snippet you write. Including a keyword will help you structure your description in a compelling way. Plus, Google sometimes highlights keywords that match users' search terms. Your meta description is like a free advertisement, so take it as a chance to convert potential visitors. Address the reader directly, pulling them in by posing a question or problem, then outlining the benefits of clicking your link. Use eye-grabbing statements and information-rich sentences. Don't waste your meta descriptions by merely duplicating snippets. When you have hundreds or thousands of pages on your site, it may seem like a good idea to just use a template and swap out a few details. But duplicate descriptions just don't look good, especially when they cover more than a handful of pages. If you don't have the time to add a carefully written, compelling snippet to every single page, it's better to let Google do the work and focus on a few key pages. Meta descriptions may not improve your SEO, but they can certainly damage your click-through rate if you engage in deliberately deceptive behavior. Be honest about what people are clicking on first and foremost. Avoid keyword stuffing. It's awkward to read it and might get you penalized or result in Google ignoring your custom description entirely. Keep these tips in mind and you'll create better meta descriptions. The techniques for crafting a meta description are similar at their core, but each type of page needs its own special touch. The way you write a snippet for a blog post, homepage, and product page varies quite a bit. Here are some tips for writing a meta description for a few key types of pages. Homepage descriptions get special treatment. This is the face of your website, so you have to make it count. Many websites write a short, one-sentence pitch, never even reaching the 160-character limit. Your job here is to sell your brand. Hard hit with a short, snappy, well-written piece that explains concisely what you do and why they should choose you. This goes for similar pages, just as your about and mission statement. For primarily informational pages, such as blog posts, you may not want your description to read like a blatant advertisement. Of course, you are making a pitch and can include a call to action, but focus on the information. When people go looking for a solution to a problem, they don't want to be advertised to. They want answers. Tell people what they'll learn when they click on this link and prove that you know what you're talking about. There are also category pages to consider. This is a hard one to write for. Most searches won't turn up a category archive, but you shouldn't miss out on an opportunity to create a compelling, converting snippet. Your best bet is to entice people by giving them a hint of the type of posts they'll find in this category and get them in a reading mood. For news-based websites and e-commerce stores, category pages play a key role as they can be crucial pages able to score higher rankings and more traffic if well optimized. Speaking of online stores, product pages will pop up in the search results when people are looking to buy something and fast. Instead of promoting your website, focus on the individual product. Use similar tactics. Write something that quickly explains what this is and why they need it. You might also include specifications such as price and other product info. You should ideally be writing a unique meta description for every product. It might be tempting to just use a template and swap out the product name, but this generic approach won't do as well as a handwritten pitch. As research shows, custom meta descriptions are able to increase your CTR up to 5.8%, which is a good outcome considering the little resources it takes to craft them out. I know, custom meta descriptions may require a little bit more time than you anticipated, but it's an activity worth doing for long-term results. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo from our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.